Dear friends who are listening to this message through the Atmadarshan TV channel, I welcome each of you to this Advent message. Today is the sixth day of Advent. During the Babylonian invasion in Israel, the armies completely crushed the Israelites. The Israelites were left helpless. And to make the matter still worse, the Babylonians carried the smartest and the healthiest Israelites to use them as their servants and slaves in their vast empire. Four of these captives were named Daniel, Mishael, Ananias, and Azariah. When they arrived in Babylonia, they were given new names like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylonia, was impressed with them. He quickly promoted these three men to leadership roles with his government and gave them authority and power over many others. They served as excellent leaders, but not everyone liked them and they had enemies. The fellow Babylonian officials became jealous of them and began to plot against these. They proposed to King Nebuchadnezzar to make a 90 feet high statue in his likeness and cover it with gold, and every official must bow down before it. And it was done. The king's commander then ordered, "When the music begins, you are ordered to fall down and worship the image. If you won't, you will be thrown into a burning fiery furnace." The music began and everyone fell down before the statue to worship except these three. They stood tall above the bent down crowd. The king was furious. Those three men responded, "O king, even if you throw us into the fiery furnace, our God will protect us. And even if God did not save us, we will not bow down before the king's statue, but the only true living God." The king was furious and ordered them to be thrown into the furnace and turn up the furnace 7 times hotter than the normal. Everyone watched, expecting them to get burned, but they saw something very, very strange. The men were not burning. The king came as close as he could to the fire and called out, "Come out of the fire, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God." And they came out without any burns on them. This is what happens when you believe in the power of God. Your enemy can throw you into the depth of the sea or to the fire, but you shall not be harmed. God's protection will encircle you. Now don't get discouraged that God did not keep you fireproof in your life. Dear friends, instead of complaining about the fire, let us make God part of everyday life. When He is with you, you cannot be defeated. You together with your God form the majority. And He is all-powerful God. He is not limited by the fire, storm, or the famines. God doesn't either deliver us from every fire. Sometimes He will take us through the fire. The good news is, God knows how to make you fire resistant. Sudden breaks cannot stop God's plan for you. Sickness, famine, flood, pandemic do not have the final say. The final decision rests only on God. So friends, when God does not stop you from entering the negative situations, remember He uses opponents to move you into your purpose. We would never know the power of God unless we fall into the storm of life where God becomes your rescuer. Your enemy may have turned up the fire 7 times hotter than the normal one for you, but they did not do that without God's approval. Worry not. God is in control, not just of your life. He is in control of your opponent's life as well. God said in Isaiah chapter 43:2, when you go through the waters, I will be with you. When you go through the rivers, they will not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. With this confidence, let us say, come, Lord Jesus, come into this loss I am going through. Come into the penury of my life. Come, Lord, into the insecurities that I experience. Come into the misery of my life. Come and set a direction for me to proceed in life. Come and set me free from all types of addictions that enslave me. Come to give me the hope that you and I together can defeat every negative force in life. Amen.